Hey, what's up, good people? This is Jesse Leach. I'm the vocalist for Killswitch Engage. And here's how music saved my life. I got involved in music around 14, 15 years old. I first heard the band Minor Threat, and the visceral anger, emotion, and just the sheer catharsis of the music is really what drove me, and something I could relate to, you know, being a young, angry kid and sort of feeling like I didn't belong in my high school. I had a small group of friends and we kind of all banded together, and punk rock and hardcore is the music that really first spoke to me, that made me want to do music, made me want to have a voice and express myself. I think the punk and hardcore music for me initially was an outlet for my emotions, and you know, when you're going through stuff at that age, you don't really know how to express them sometimes in words. So sometimes just the simple act of being aggressive on a microphone and screaming, or getting behind a drum set or a guitar, it's able to do something that words couldn't do. And I've stuck with it my whole life, but essentially that first moment when I felt something that I couldn't explain in words, and I was able to channel that through music, that's when I kind of realized I was going to be hooked for life. As I grew up, and being able to perform music in front of people and larger audiences and have a more intense fan base and people who are actually getting what I was saying, just made me realize how important music really was, not just to me, but to the people around me, and how I could actually affect others with it. And I think initially when I started out, it was like kind of all about me, you know, because when you're younger, that's what you go through. But now that I'm in my 30s and I look back at my life, I've realized the reason I'm still doing it isn't just for me. It's for the people that are able to read my lyrics or come to our shows and are able to blow off steam in the pit or dancing and singing along. All those things are the reason why I still do it, because I realize how important it was to me when I was younger. And I've carried that through my life, but it's become much more of a community thing, a give and take, where it's not just about me, it's about everybody else who's listening and that really cares. And to me, even in my own life, I went through a period of my life where I considered taking my own life, and music and my faith in God were the only two things that kept me going. And I don't know what I'd do without it. If you're out there and you're feeling low, you're feeling down, you're unsure about the world around you, you even think about potentially taking yourself out, life is so fleeting and so beautiful. You do not know what tomorrow holds. I've lost dear friends of mine to suicide, and it's to this day, it still brings me so much pain. And all of your friends around you that really care about you, you have no idea the impact that your suicide would have on people. Reach out to anybody. I mean, your friends, your family, a therapist, sometimes even strangers. You never know what life will bring. Someone could say a simple phrase to you and it could change your whole life around. I know it's done that for me. When I got to my lowest of low, it was just a few simple phrases that changed my whole perspective and brought me out of my depression. And it's something that you may struggle with the rest of your life. I still struggle with anxiety and depression. Thankfully not on a daily basis, but I have bouts of it. And the last thing you want to do is take your own life, because there's so much beauty around you. There's so much that life has to offer you. So just please, like, do yourself a big favor and do your friends and family a big favor and reach out and ask for help, because people can't read your minds.